Hello, my lovely subscribers. I'm Lachey, and welcome back to another video. Today, we're going to be reviewing a speed art of me doing my latest TikTok. Follow me on TikTok at unique.nugget. I'll put it on the screen right now. This is just a speed draw. I'm going to be voicing over it and, like, talking about Steven Universe stuff and just basically how great the show is. And yeah, so first, the idea of this TikTok was Bryson Tiller's Let Him Know. I don't know if you've seen that trend, but it was like, who is he? And then they say, I'm him and stuff. So I did that. You can go watch the video on my TikTok. Or, you know what, I'll just post it at the end of this video. So first off, I drew this because I was waiting for my sister to get off of work, and she had to get off of work at 1:30. In the morning, so I had nothing better to do, and I couldn't go on Instagram because then I'd see spoilers, and I couldn't go on YouTube because then I'd see spoilers, because it was way past 7 o'clock and that's when the episodes would be out. So I was like, bro, they're gonna freaking say something and I'm gonna get heartbroken, and I didn't have time for that. So I just went on Pinterest. Good thing there was no spoilers on Pinterest. I'm really happy for that. Went on Pinterest, was looking at some Steven Universe comics and stuff, and then, like, I was listening to music too. And I was like, I feel like drawing. So then I opened up my art program, and I was gonna start drawing something, but I forgot what I was gonna draw. I was gonna draw something else, I know that. And then the song that came on was Bryson Tiller, and I was like, yo, that gives me a mad idea about Steven. So then I got that idea, and I went go look him up, and and then I started drawing him, and then it came out like you're seeing right now. I mean, it was a bit of a struggle. I mean, like, the simplest characters sometimes are the hardest to draw, like, no cap. I mean, like, hard drawings are hard to draw and stuff, but, like, think about it, like, SpongeBob. Like, he looks so simple, but, like, I don't know. It's just so hard to draw, like, simple characters, because, like, they don't have anything, like, I don't know how to say it, just, it's hard to draw simple characters. But I was able to draw them, and then, like, at the end, I drew them in, like, kind of my style a little bit, but, like, stayed similar to the Steven Universe style. I just want to say, as I'm about to start talking about it, best cartoon ever. Best plot twist, all that. I loved it. I started watching it, like, maybe a year or 2 years ago, and then I stopped watching it, and then I found out there was a movie. I don't know why I stopped watching it. Then I found out there was a movie. I started watching it again this month. And then the quarantine for the writers happened. So I'm basically watching it, like, from season one. 56 episodes, I'm watching it by myself. And then my sister got into it. I made her get into it, and we were on season two. But we didn't watch season one all over again because I didn't feel like doing all that. And it took too long to catch up and stuff. And then it started getting serious. I mean, it already was serious, but, like at some point, it just got really... No, I think she was in, like, it was the middle of season two, not, like, somewhere near season three. So then it started getting really serious and stuff, you know. It's really good. Rebecca really is going somewhere. She's a good artist. She's a good story writer. I think she wrote all of it, right? Because it said creator. So, yeah, loved it. It was amazing. The ending, spectacular. I'm so happy it didn't end on, like, a bad note. Like, she puts in these sly, like, things. Like, at the end of every Steven Universe episode, he's leaving. And, like, that's just, like, the most... That's some good foreshadowing right there. I mean, like, I don't know how you would... It's just amazing. It's so hard to explain. Like, it's just so good. Like, oh my gosh. I love cartoons. Because, like, I'm a cartoonist and I'm an artist and stuff. And, like, I don't draw many realistic stuff. I like cartoons. And I love music. I like musicals and stuff. Best of both worlds. Put them together. I'd watch it all the time. So, yeah. And, like, the songs are catchy. And, like, they have meaningful, like, topics and stuff. Like, I've never seen, like, a cartoon, like, put such relatable topics into, like, a show. Like, the epilogue, like, Steven Universe Future, that stuff was deep. Like, you didn't want it to be relatable because, like, that's a character. He's so wholesome and, like, always happy all the time. You don't want that to be that way. But, like, the happiest people are always, like, the happiest people have, are the saddest sometimes. Like, because they're always happy and they're making other people happy and they think they need to be happy for other people to be happy. Like, putting their emotions before everybody else. I mean, putting other people's emotions before theirs. But, like, it was just, oh my gosh. Like, oh my gosh. I keep saying like, but I can't talk because I don't usually do voiceovers. But geez, Louise. That was amazing. I loved it so much. And that's why I'm drawing this. I usually don't draw that much fan art and stuff. But unless it's like really, really good. I mean, I drew Stranger Things. Like, that goes up with Stranger Things. No cap. Goes up with Stranger Things. Because Stranger Things has a really good plot, too. Like, you don't know what's coming next and stuff. And, like, with Steven Universe, it's, like, basically the same. That plot twist, you didn't know. You didn't know. If you didn't know, then you're weird. Because why are you thinking that way anyway? JK. But, yeah, like, it caught me off guard. Like, oh, my gosh. You don't know how many times my heart was beating so fast during this whole series. Like, a few days ago when episode 17 came out for Steven Universe Future, for the quarantine, they let out early, and I accidentally saw something spoiled on YouTube, and I was like, am I missing something? And then I realized that we missed the episode, and I'm like, oh my gosh, my heart was beating so fast that day. I was so scared. Oh my gosh, almost gave me a heart attack. But yeah, Steven Universe is amazing. Favorite character, Garnet. I feel like that's a lot of people's favorite character. I mean, I love everybody, and like Steven and stuff. He has a beautiful voice, by the way. They all have beautiful voices, but like, and like Steven has his like own career with music, and he has like a musical and stuff. I still have to finish it, but one of my favorite songs by him is Showtime Interlude, I think it's 4, and War, because that one's good too. So, yeah, he has a really beautiful voice. And I think Connie, the voice actor for Connie's in the interlude one. So, I like watching, like, the animatics. I think that's how you say it. Animatics for him, where they pair it with Steven Universe. It's, these animators out here, they be tripping sometimes. Get me in my feeling, y'all. Okay, so I think I'm finishing up here, adding, like, regular shading, which I'm not the best at shading, but there I am adding shading and stuff. And then I added my little makeshift logo, and then there's the final product with all the little bedazzles and glowing stuff. And here's a little comic thing that I made for the TikTok, it all in one picture so that you can see. Yeah, and then here's the video. Okay, that is all. I hope you enjoyed my little voiceover and enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to give it a like, make sure to share with your friends, and follow all my social media so that you can keep up to date with my art. I'm Lachey, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.